Today, why have we lost our peace of mind and how to find that inner peace again? Are you looking for the peace of mind? Many people think that they can have the peace of mind when they have enough money, or when they get the right job, or when they are able to buy the right house. But inner peace does not come with material possessions. Inner peace does not come from outside. It is found within. On this earth, there is no place that you can find inner peace. And no amount of money can buy that inner peace. Peace of mind is invaluable and immeasurable. Our minds would become serene and tranquil like a still lake when we are free from grudges and unforgiveness, excessive pleasures and attachments. Deep-seated hatred, unforgiveness and grudges are the main reasons for many mental illnesses. So, inner peace is the biggest gift and satisfaction one can have. Today is the Divine Mercy Sunday. In today's Gospel from St. John, we see Jesus appearing to the apostles after his resurrection. That evening, the disciples were locked up with fear behind doors. Because they were afraid of Jews, the disciples were hiding in the upper room. They witnessed what happened to their master. They saw how Jesus died a cruel death on a cross. Now they are living with the fear of death. As a result of that, they are locked up and isolated. They didn't want anybody to know that they were hiding in Jerusalem. But suddenly, the risen Lord passes through the walls. The locked doors couldn't stop him, and Jesus appeared in their midst. Jesus' first words to the apostles are, "Peace be with you." In fact, Jesus said it twice, "Peace be with you." Further, the Lord told them, "Receive the Holy Spirit," and gave them the power to forgive sins. After the tragic death of Jesus on the cross, the disciples were heartbroken. Although they saw the empty tomb, they were perplexed. Their mind was not at peace. Therefore, the risen Lord comes with his healing, "Peace be with you." How much of a consolation and happiness they would have felt. Meeting with the risen Lord cleared their doubts and took away their fears. Their troubled hearts are now at peace. Jesus is alive and with them. They experienced the divine mercy of the Lord. When the hour of persecution came, they all ran away, abandoning Jesus. Some rejected Jesus. Some doubted him. But now, risen Jesus has forgiven all that and come into their midst. Maybe they were in tears, with tears of joy. This is the divine mercy the apostles experienced with the resurrection of the Lord. His divine mercy brought them inner peace and joy. In today's first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, it is mentioned that the whole community of believers was one in heart and one in mind. The first Christians shared their belongings and they did not claim any private ownership. The early Christians translated mercy into action. They sold their material possessions and brought what they received before the apostles. The apostles distributed it to the members according to their need. Because of their detachment from possessions and attitude of sharing, they lived with inner peace. Today, what has happened to us? We are over-attached to material wealth and we keep on hoarding our possessions. As a result of that, we have lost our inner peace. And because of their greed for wealth, many people are living with unrest and sicknesses. In the present, the unreasonable fears and anxiety in us have taken away our inner peace. Today, we are worried about our future. We are afraid about our jobs, our exams, and our loved ones. There's a deep-seated feeling of insecurity in us. But if we truly believe that the risen Lord is amidst us, what can harm us? If Lord is living with us, who can be against us? Moreover, we have lost our inner peace because we are holding past grudges and we are not ready to forgive others. The risen Lord gave them the power to forgive others' sins. Therefore, if you have lost your inner peace, forgive and forget others. Do a good confession and have the peace of mind. In this blessed season of Easter, let us do away with unforgiveness excessive attachments and greed for possessions. Then we will have that inner peace of mind. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.